langsung dikatakan sama salah satu motivator dunia, mengatakan bahwa negara Malaysia ini menjadi barisan teratas atau urutan teratas daftar negara muslim yang wajib banget dikunjungi. Assalamualaikum, Elsa di sini. Hai guys, hai semua, halo tetangga. Gimana kabar teman-teman semua? Semoga sehat selalu, semoga bahagia selalu, dan semoga hari teman-teman semua selalu good day. Selamat datang di channel YouTube Elsa Widianti Putri. Hari ini aku akan reaction dari salah satu YouTuber besar juga nih guys, dari luar negara. Namanya Muhammad Hijab, di mana dia mengatakan rakyat Malaysia ini another level gitu. Wah, apa nih maksudnya? Nanti kita lihat vlog dari Bang Muhammad ini guys. Tapi sebelum dimulai video reaction-nya, seperti biasa aku mau ajakin teman-teman semua dulu untuk subscribe channel ini dan aktifkan lonceng notifikasinya supaya tidak ketinggalan updatean terbaru dari channel ini. Dan bagi teman-teman yang mau request, bisa banget DM di Instagram aku di @elsawidiantiputri ataupun join langsung di grup Telegram aku. Linknya di deskripsi di bawah ini. Teman-teman bisa join langsung, free, gratis. Siapapun boleh gabung asalnya baik. Yaudah, tanpa berlama-lama, tanpa membuang masa, jumlah kita mulai video reaction-nya. Are you ready? Let's go.
Alright guys, we're here in Kuala Lumpur, the capital city of Malaysia. Look how beautifully it is designed. Excellent infrastructure, one of the best I would say in Southeast Asia. And we're here with the main man himself, the Dawah powerhouse, Fadli Burhan. How you doing, Fadli? Okay.
Masyaallah, it's really nice to have you here, Brother Hijab.
We're here in the heart of Kuala Lumpur.
Namanya memang Hijab.
The capital of Malaysia, and this is these are
twin towers, and these are the tallest buildings. The tallest twin tower buildings.
Kangen banget sama Malaysia, weh.
One of, I think, not the in the world.
Kuala Lumpur does have its fair share of high rises. You could say Kuala Lumpur is one of the most developed Muslim cities in the world. In fact, you could make an argument that it's the most developed, probably right behind Dubai and Abu Dhabi and Doha. So where are we today?
We are now at Masjid Putra, one of the most iconic masjid here in Malaysia actually.
Masjid Putra. Nah, ini masjid yang aku kunjungi, weh. Masjid Pink.
What do you find?
It's beautiful. Let's take a look at it a little bit.
Masjid Pink ini kan? Masjid yang berwarna pink satu-satunya. Yang ada di dunia. Mau sampai 2000 pengunjung.
So this is Putrajaya Mosque. It's the most famous mosque in Malaysia. Very beautiful architecture.
Masyaallah.
I'd like to know more about where they've been inspired from.
Kemarin aku tak sempat ngerekod banyak sih guys.
Areas of inspiration. Very interesting. Huge dome. They do the mosque tour here. You can see over there.
Tapi ketika aku masuk kemarin guys, dalamnya masyaallah banget sih.
About to start an event here. We've got the main man. Masyaallah. We've got the brothers here. He's behind the scenes.
Oh, ngisi acara dia di sini.
Masyaallah.
Oh, ngisi acara. Dia motivator
right
kayaknya ya.
You see how tall I am in this country.
Tinggi banget dia.
I'm taller than usual.
It is.
Oh, come here.
Oh my God, look at this.
Okay, so we've got Brother Lim, mashallah, who's the director of the IDT Center, one of the big IDT centers in Southeast Asia. I want to ask you, Dr. Lim, how did you get to the position that you're in? How did you become Muslim in the first place?
I was born as a Buddhist in a Buddhist family.
Yeah.
Oh,
I became
I love
a Christian
you
at the age of 13. So I was in Christianity for nearly 14 years. How do I get to know Islam? One of my friends brought a debate between bidat and swagat. I do not know much anything about Islam. But through this debate, it opened my mind to do research and study about comparative religion. And one of the things that attracted me most is the verse in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah.
Surah Al-Baqarah.
255. And this is the most special ayat for me. The most special ayat. Why? Because this ayat actually teaches me how to differentiate who is God, who is not God. Who is divine, who is not divine.
This is ayat al-Kursi.
Yeah, who is almighty, who is not almighty.
So what's this called?
Nasi lemak.
Nasi lemak is my favorite Malaysian food.
Right. I've had rendang. I've had it has a delicate mixture of, you know, spice. And also it's got the carb.
Tapi nasi lemak like Malaysia tu memang enak. Weh, nasi lemak di bandara KLIA.
The nature of the
itu enak banget, weh, asli.
Spicy, bro? No, not at all.
How do you find the sambal, the spicy sauce?
It's nice. It's very
sambalnya
good.
Pedas.
I think most people will be able to tolerate it.
Yeah, nice.
Pedas. Enak gitu. Ah, pengen.
Yes, I've tried the rendang.
Makan nasi lemak lagi.
The most famous dish. Mm-hmm. The beef one.
Yeah, the beef one. Yeah.
But I prefer this by far.
Okay, nice, cool. Mm. So what do you have to say about this is your final day. You are already at the airport leaving for London. Mm. So what do you have to say about Malaysia, bro?
Malaysia is a beautiful country. Yeah. It's one of the countries that, honestly, if someone's had enough of the West and wants a Muslim alternative, this should be at the top of their list. They have to at least visit it and see what it's about before making a decision. Because a lot of people just had enough of the West now. They don't want to live in Europe anymore because of what's happening in school systems or whatever. And they're looking for alternatives. So we've spoken about, I mean, I've done a bit of touring in Pakistan. We spoke about that. In Islamabad, it's an alternative. Riyadh, yes. Dubai, Abu Dhabi, yes. They're all fine alternatives. Doha, Qatar, Istanbul. But Kuala Lumpur is definitely up there.
Okay, ini adalah kali pertama Bang Hijab mengunjungi Malaysia untuk sepertinya mengadakan tour motivasi mungkinnya kalau dilihat-lihat ya guys, di mana ada konten pembahasan tentang mualaf, ada konten pembahasan tentang agama Islam. Kayaknya sih dia seorang motivator dan lagi tour ke Malaysia gitu. Dan Malaysia menjadi alternatif yang pas, yang baik nih, terutama untuk orang Muslim. Kalau udah capek banget sama negara barat, Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur bisa menjadi alternatif yang paling baik untuk merefreshingkan kehidupan, merefreshingkan pemikiran gitu. Malaysia menjadi salah satu negara Muslim yang baik sih, yang bagus, nyaman, damai, yang tenang. Jikalau ada orang-orang dari luar negara yang ingin hijrah, menurut aku pribadi, langsung dikatakan sama salah satu motivator dunia, mengatakan bahwa negara Malaysia ini menjadi barisan teratas atau urutan teratas daftar negara Muslim yang wajib banget dikunjungi. Nah, ini langsung diakui loh guys. Rasakan ketenangan, rasakan keamanan, kedamaian di negara Malaysia. Dan untuk video kali ini cukup sekian. Bagi teman-teman yang suka sama video ini, jangan lupa untuk like, komen, dan subscribe. Dan kita ketemu di next video. Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum. Thank you.